welcome you to our Move at Home Club, where we work out to reverse lifestyle diseases. We want to prevent and reverse them. So let us pray to begin. Our gracious, wonderful Father, thank you for your mighty blessings in our lives and for this opportunity to come and work out. And so we ask that you will allow your Holy Spirit to be the instructor of this class, we pray. And we give you thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. Let us start moving. Heel to the front. Heel. Just enjoy it, okay? Yeah. Heel. Now cross the heel in front. Cross the heel in front. And 4, 3, and back, and now walk. Ready? Come on. Now swing those arms right out as you walk and lift the leg higher than knees. Remember to tuck those abs in, right in to your back. And we start moving. Yeah. We're moving 4 up and 4 back. Ready? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4 and back. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. You're stepping forward and backward. And the same leg starting off. For me, it's this one. Stand up right here and keep it going. And now from here on, we are doing exercises for 45 seconds. Alright, so each exercise is 45 seconds. The first one we're going to do is come on, just kick. We're taking it nice and low for now. Swing the arms forward with each kick. Going to do it for the 45 seconds, but raising them higher. All right, and reach only one side. Ready? And up, kick. And we're keeping this for 45 seconds. Make sure reach and touch those toes so that you work deep down in all those ab muscles. You're working to strengthen them. You're gonna tuck your abs in if you have fat in your abs to lose that. Just one more, and you get to walk it gently. Nice and easy. Yeah. And you get ready for the next side, doing those moves for 40, that move for 45 seconds. Here you go. Kick, kick. Up with the knee and kick out. And one more. Get a few seconds, about 15 seconds rest. The next one is heel up, right here. You step back and heel up. Come on, let's do it. Squeeze the arms, the tricep press. Bring the heels up as close to the glutes as possible. And squeeze. Feet. Get rid of all those cellulite. Come on, one more, and down, and we get ready for the next side. You will find from doing these exercises that all the cellulite, the diet, will go away. Come on, up, next side, yes. Then we'll get those triceps. Squeeze and hold for about 2 seconds. One, two. One, two. When you squeeze your arms, you should feel it all in your back. Huh? Squeeze. Is to take the leg out. I'm gonna keep the arms out. Come on, out. Reach and see if you can touch your fingers out there. Or get in line with it, your toes. Your legs are longer than your arms, so you should be right outside your fingers with your toes there. Reaching up. Straight leg, come on. One more, and down. All right, you get to bring down your arms too. Keeping your arms on stretch is a great exercise for the arms right here. Now for the next side. Ready and up. Up. For this towards our hip area, and of course, working on our abs, right? And one more. Right, the next one is straight leg to the front. Tip out, stretch one arm out, and touch. Touch. Make sure you're touching your toes, that way you're working your abs, your mid and lower abs. When you raise your legs, you work your lower abs. You bend over, you're working that mid ab area. Yes. All right. And that is your core area. Remember, your core is what carries you. All right, ready? To the next side. Here we go. Remember, breathe in and out through your nostrils only. No mouth breathing. One more. Down. Walk, walk. The next one is to bring both arms up. Pull down. Pull down from behind. Pull, pull, turn your knees and toes out, pull. When you turn your knees, you end up working your inner thighs, pull. Pull down, come on, pull right there, pull right behind by your thighs, so you're going down into that squeeze, and one more, and oh, you're feeling all your inner thighs, good, so we get ready for that next side, woo, those inner thighs are burning there, huh, nice, come on, next side, turn the knees and toes. Pull down, pull, pull, and squeeze, squeeze, squeeze and hold right there, yes, squeeze. The benefit of the move is when you squeeze and hold for a second or two. Let the arm outstretch helps to stretch the other side and down. So when we're doing it like this, we do not need to come back and stretch the side. Okay? And now we do some squats with arm curls. Ready? Wide squat, going down. Squeeze, come up and press down. Go down, press. down, down, come on, down, down, up right there. If you have problems, you know, injury, some issue, you can hold on to a chair as best as you can and just move. You don't have to go right down, you can stay right here. Just flexing those muscles in the quads and the hamstrings will do a great work for you. And we way past our 45 seconds there. Yeah, it will do a great deal for you because it's strengthening those muscles. And the stronger those muscles are, the better for your recovery from injury. With proper diet, you'll find that the ligaments will grow back again. Oh yes, don't let anybody fool you, the ligaments do grow back. Yes, and your knees, all those problems in the knees and joints will end up disappearing. All right, and take every opportunity to work and stretch out any area, because sometimes parts of the body may shrink as we get older for different reasons. All right, and now we walk fast for 45 seconds. Remember, you're landing on the ball of your feet. If you cannot walk like this, sit on the chair and just move your legs up and down. That will work. And your arms. And you are working out. Take it down. The next move is out, out, you're stepping out on the ball of your feet, and the rest of us will do it in the pendulum swing. Ready? Come on. If you're sitting on a chair, just sit to the edge of the chair and take one leg out, in the other one out, in. Just a few more seconds and take it down right here. So that was our pendulum swing. Take a few seconds, yes. Next one, we're going to skip it for 45 seconds. Remember, breathe in and out through your nostrils, breathe deeply. Okay, here's one. Breathe in. Deeply, that is. And blow out slowly, take your time. Breathe in. Blow out. Breathe in. Blow out. And we're going to skip it. Ready? Skip. Make sure you get it high off the rope to pass under your feet. last five seconds with more kind of things, right? Okay. And take it down. Okay. Walking. Do not stop. Just keep moving. It's an easy move. We bring back to squat. Squat and arm curl again. Ready? Go down. Squeeze. You gotta squeeze those arms. Squeeze. Remember, you start with your upper body forward and you're driving your glutes down into the floor. Squeeze with the ball with your heels. Squeeze. Now, squeeze with your heels as you come up. That way, you're going to feel all your thighs working. Your toes are not involved in this at all. Squeeze. Squeeze on your heels and come up and hold that squeeze. Down, come up and hold the squeeze. Down, come up and hold the squeeze. Now shuffle those feet in. Get a walk for a few seconds here. All right, and now we're going to do brisk walking for 45 seconds. Come on. We have to make sure we get the heart rate up. Yes. You can move to the side. Look at those side muscles. You have just 2 more seconds. Take it down. Now we go back to those squats. This time, starting with the hands, with a fist right inside by your armpit here. We're gonna stretch right out. When you do that, let your thumb face the floor and squeeze. As you squeeze, you're gonna feel it all in the back. And of course, you're working out your arms. All right, here we go, go down. Remember to squeeze on your heels to come up and squeeze, let your thumbs face the floor and squeeze there, feel it all in your upper back. Down and up, squeeze. Down, squeeze on the heels and come up. Up. Make sure you feel it in your back and your arms when you squeeze there. And squeeze. One more. And we're getting ready to go back. This time we're going to do jumping jacks. Now, if you cannot do jumping jacks, all right, what you can do is bring the arm up and leg out. Bring it in, and next one, out and in. Out, in. Everybody, let us do that while we prepare for the 45 seconds of jumping jacks. Out, in, you clap at the top, clap at the end. out, in, out, in. And now put it 45 seconds. One, come on, yeah. Take your time, land on the ball of your feet. Take it down. Now, kick to the front, heel to the front. Recover the time. Breathe in, deeply, blow out. Breathe in. You get a cheat and blow out through your mouth. In and blow out. For me, blowing out through my mouth is just not, doesn't work because I want to stay with this energizer. So I choose to breathe in and out always through the nostrils. That is where you get all the energy. Take your time going out now through your nostrils. In and blow out. Should be feeling a lot better by now. All right. And now we start back walking. And we are going to touch toes. And with the legs out, we're going to keep one arm up, we're going to reach and touch, and next side and touch, okay? Ready? Let us do that. One, up, go right down and come up, down, up, down, up, down, up. Down, up, and you realize what is happening with the other arm. You're working shoulders as well with the one outstretch when you bend forward. And one more on each side. And you stay right here. We get ready for the next move. And that is right here. Bring the arm and touch the toe. And the next one, take that other one behind. So you're swinging the arms and going down. So you're doing a twist. Point the toes out and reach for those toes and twist the arms. Let me make sure I'm doing for you to see behind. Twist. You're gonna come right up and okay, right there. Have a few seconds and we're gonna come right back to this same exercise. Ready? And here we go, down, up. Make sure to get wider, feel it more in your inner thighs. Thank you. Don't press them on your heels. And straight knees, eh? And this is the last one. Top of the feet. And let us have a water break at this time. So take some water, and if you have weights, it will be a good time to bring out your weights, because we are going to do some serious arm workout. Yeah, yeah, we gotta build those arms. All right, so arms and shoulders, here we go. All right. Okay, take some water. Now we did some arm curls already. Three weights, which means without weights. So now you can afford to add, whether it's 5 pounds, but you do not want to go the heaviest weight. So if you are starting with 5 pounds, that is what you work with, then you can increase to 10 and 15 as you see fit, okay? You are the best person to gauge that, okay? All right. So I'm choosing to do 5 pounds. We'll start with both hands in front here and squeeze up. That's working the biceps, so you should feel it really pumping up right here as you squeeze. And then as you press down, you will also feel your triceps right there. Your triceps actually on fire there. Ready? Squeeze up and down. We are doing will be 21 reps. All right, we're doing it at different stages. Okay, still working those biceps. So right here, you're gonna come up halfway. Right there, squeeze, make sure you're squeezing. That way you're working your lower arm. Right, and down. Come up, that's two. Right here, and down. Up here, three, four. Make sure you squeeze in those, you're squeezing here. And if you do not have weights, that's fine. Five, four, squeeze. And even though I have the weights, I'm still squeezing. Otherwise, I do not get the benefit of my body weight. If I'm not squeezing, I'm right here, you're coming up and squeeze and back right here. Take it all the way down and all the way up. One, two, four, five, space. Those arms, yes. Now this is one of the ways that bodybuilders are exercise doing these 21 pulls. And so what you do, you increase the weights and really take it up a few levels there. All right, and now you're gonna turn the arms out. And so your palms will be faced out like this. And you come up at the side and squeeze right here. And we're gonna count 15. 1, 2, 3. Now go down into a squat. 4, 6, 7. Time, 9. Going for the burn, right? So we have 5 more. 5, 4, 1. And squeeze right here. Squeeze there and feel all your triceps. Yeah. Bring in the arms there. Okay. And now the other one you're doing is so that inner part here. So we're gonna bring up the arms and cross. The only way we can avoid the cross is one arm at a time. But here's where, when we cross, get to save on time. All right? So go down into that little spot there. Come up and cross. 2, 3, press right out and feel all your back and your triceps on fire, right there. Okay, so that is what we want to get, right? So now 4, squeeze. 5, squeeze, and squeeze when you go down. 6, 3 more to go. 3, 2, 1. The amazing thing about these exercises is that if you have extra fat, it will get rid of the fat while replacing that fat with muscles. So you may not even find that you're losing weight, but your clothes are fitting you differently, as in slacker. And if you do not have fat, then all it's doing is building muscles. Okay, you cannot lose what you do not have. All right, so this is the wonderful thing about these exercises, whether you're small or you're trying to lose weight, you're overweight, everything, it works, all right? And what is important too is that if you're overweight and while you're losing the fat and replacing the fat with muscles, you will not get the loose skin. You know, people were big, and when they lose weight, you have all these big bulges of skin, loose skin. You will not get it when you work out like this. This is a nice thing about it, all right? Yeah, and then you get to rub down yourself using that castor oil to get rid of the stretch marks, yes. So that you do not look ugly to yourself and your spouse as you lose weight, all right? So that worked out our biceps. I probably just want to do something for the triceps, and we come back with one last set of bicep of the ankle with a little heavier weight. So leaning forward and stretching right up and squeezing for those triceps. We did so many biceps that we need to do some little tricep with the weights. Ready? And squeeze up. Only 10 we're doing with this. 2, 3, 4. Seven, 3 more. 8, 5. I know when you're doing this, you feel like your triceps are ripping. You actually feel the fiber in the muscles ripping. Okay. Now we try and go a little heavier. If you have weights, heavier weights, we do 10 reps of with the heavier weights right here. The 10 reps. Remember, if you do not have weight, just squeeze. Clench that fist tight till you start to vibrate. And take your time squeezing and come up. I'm squeezing with the weights here. And go down right here. And you squeeze. And controlling the movement, going back down. Okay? All right. So here I'm going to use these, it's about 12 pumps on each side. Ready? And we're going for 10. 10 reps. Up. 1, 2, 3, 4. Do that is to do one arm at a time. Okay? Alright. So that with our arms, and now we work our shoulders. What we're going to do with the shoulders, do press-ups while doing squats. Alright, you can use your weights. Ready? We're going down, press up, 1. Down, press right up, 2. 3. 4. 5. 6. 7. 8. Going to do 3 moves in 1. That is forward, in, out to the side, in, and then pull chin ups and press down. You can do it with weights or you can do it without weights. Just remember, clench the fist and work it. Ready? Remember, those shoulders need a little workout here. Come on, up. Make sure you squeeze in and down to the sides. You should feel it all at the side here. Squeeze and come in. And as you come in, you're working on your chest. Bring the hands up to your chin and press down. Now forward, in, out, in, out chin ups. Pull up, make sure your elbows are high over your head there, and press down and flip all of your sides. Forward, in, out, in, chin ups. And press down, forward, in, out. Up. And down. Forward, in, out. Forward, in, out. This all in your back. Forward, in, out, in. Chin up, press down. Nice and easy with the shoulders, right? Okay, there is one I know some of the, you like. I would use weights for that. You only need one. So you're working from side to side, and working the back. All right? Working the back, and of course, what carries the arm? The shoulders, okay? Working the back and the sides here. So we go down to the toes and come up, right across. And then you come across, you're going to feel it right here. Right here along this. Down and up. Make sure you're bending the knees. Bend the knees here. You go down, you bend the knee on this side. Come up, bend the knee here. So wherever the hand goes, you bend the knee. Hand is out on this side, knee. Hand comes in here, left, out. One more. Side, knee, bend the knee, go down to the toes, and up. Make sure you bend the knee in that side lunge. Down with your glutes, five, your glutes, you do not want your knees to ever pass your toes. Five more to go, five, four, three, two, one, down and up. Put the feet in, have some water, and then we will do some more work, this time working on those legs, all right? Hope you tried the hot water, the pinch of salt. It is very refreshing indeed. Now, if you have a chair nearby, I suggest that you have a chair nearby, or you can have a broomstick to use to help balance. But let me show you how to use the broomstick. On the flat end of the broomstick, because generally with the broomstick, one end is round to the top and the other one is flat. I so put in the flat part on the floor and your hand on top here. That is how you're going to hold on. Take it just a little bit away from you, right by your hip in front there. You take your leg up, and now you're going to squeeze out the other leg. The knee is bent slightly, and so you maintain your help to maintain your balance and not damage your knee there as well. Okay, hold, keep your abs in, that also helps. And remember, we want 6 packs. The only way you're going to get that 6-pack is by tucking in your abs. Okay. Of course, on diet, you cannot be drinking juice with sugar and expect to get 6-pack abs. All right? Bring that leg up. Your toes are pointing forward, and then you squeeze. Keeping it high right there, press on that broomstick and bring it in so that you work hamstring when you come in and out. In and out, that's 2. In, out, 3, 4, 5. You can stretch out the other arm. 6, 7. You gotta keep that thigh up. 9, 10. And you're feeling all your palm muscles on the other side working. That's what you want. Your calves and your hamstring were all, and your quads were all firing right there. Now let's try the other side. Right here. Remember, if you take your leg down low, you're not going to get that benefit. And if you're on a chair, you just get to the edge of your chair and you do it. That's all. Bring it. Bring the heel in the back and then stretch right out. Okay? All right. Now let us do it. Make sure that knee, the other knee, is bent slightly. All right. Now raise up on that other side. You can stretch out your arms so that works your arms too. And now squeeze in, right in, and out, and squeeze. So we're working both hamstring and quads together. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and down. Now, I chose to do this standing rather than on the floor because this helps with balance. It is important to try to balance between all the different types of exercises. So we have the aerobic type where, you know, we run around, we do jumping jacks and so on. And that is great. We also need the flexibility. And even we get that from the movement of the hip. we get that in some of the other movements, the flexibility. We need the anabolic, the resistance. So that's why we squeeze and bring up the muscles or we weight. And then we must do balancing. And this is what this balancing is about, okay? All right. Now, right here, with the feet out, just outside the hip. Hand on the broomstick, okay? Gonna bring the leg up and out, out right here. And you're gonna keep swinging it out for 10. All right, so you may need to bring your feet in a little bit closer. All right, and you take it out right here. 1, 2, squeeze. 3, go right out. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10, and done. Okay. Best of us could lose balance at any time. All right. Now we try for the next side. So you're going across and out, right out. Ready? Press on that broomstick there. Out and over on that side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. One more, 10, and done. You felt all your muscles, the upper part of the quads right up here and your inner thighs. Okay. Now, talking about balancing, we are going to engage some more muscles here with balancing. Now, this is something that you may take lightly. You start here, I have a line in front of me. So I'm gonna try to walk on this line. Okay, right here, stepping 1 foot in front of the other without falling over. 1 foot in front. So I want you all to try and do that. 1 foot in front, the other. Now step back. You're not going back far, but you're lining up the feet, okay? You're not going out, but right back. And bring it right in line every time you go back or forward, right back. All right, right here. And now forward. So this helps with maintaining balance because you're coming right in front each time. But here is a catch. The catch is, now let me step back. The catch is to do it with your eyes closed. Yes, that's when you know that you have good balance. All right, so now you're going to start, you're going forward and see what happens when you close your eyes. Ready? Ready? All right, let's go forward. And now the next one forward. Now you feel how you start to lose your balance right there? You can take your hands out. And now the next leg forward. Okay. The next one forward. Take your time, focus on what you're doing. All right. Now the next one forward. And now the next one forward. All right, now take it back. Back, line up. Okay, now this is fun, right? And now back, next leg, getting back. Back, next one back. Next one back. You know, we're cheating a little bit, open the eyes. This is for a brief second and back. All right. Now, that is something that you can practice, you can do during the day, do a few steps and work on your balance. And now just for fun, as we warm, I guess we are more warmed up already, right? And that is, you know, to do the catwalk, all right? Which is taking one leg in front. All right, now you gotta move hip with it. And you are taking one foot over the other. Just like what we did with the balancing, but just a little bit wider steps or longer steps. All right, so take it cross in front and then the other one and cross, cross, cross. All right, take it back, back. And now cross. You gotta move the arms with it. All right, and now taking it a little bit faster, and then you're going to spin to come back. All right, spin around to come back. All right, ready? And walk. And now right here, when you get to the top, under your heel and toes, you're going to turn to get back in the opposite direction. Just having some fun here, all right? So walk and turn and walk. All right. Okay, let us breathe in deeply and blow out. Breathe in. Blow out slowly. Now standing on one leg, which means you're going to bend the knee on the other. Stand on one leg, breathe in, and blow out. One more time, drop the leg. Now come up, breathe in, blow out. Next side, breathe in. Hold it right there for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go out slowly, slowly, as you drop the leg slowly. All right. One more time. Breathe in. And blow out. And now for the idea to lift pose, let us breathe in. And hold that pose, all right? And that is right here. And stretch right out. Or you could come in with your, with that leg right in there. And hold it, hold it. Remember, we are balancing to end right here. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Come on, you think you can make 10 more seconds right there? 9, 8, 7, all right, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, next side. Ready, come on, and let's do this. Have a good time. Yeah. So now we go for the 10 seconds, right? 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and down. Okay, let us pray to end. Oh, gracious, loving Father, we thank you for the strength and the health to come and wake out. And now we ask you for spiritual health, that we focus on you, that we grow in grace as we spend time in studying your word and working towards helping other people. We ask you to be with us during this day, that we make right decisions, that the encounters we have with people and in different situations, you give us the wisdom to deal with them. Bless our families, our friends, our communities and countries. We pray and we thank you in the name of Jesus, giving us health and strength. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you and keep you until next time. Bye-bye.